preceptor of preceptors, my guru. With eyes reflecting divine bliss, Rudraksh earrings swinging from his ears, long wavy beard, forehead decorated with sandal paste and sacred ash, long hair bound into a circular braid with a coronet. Yes, only he can be my preceptor, my guru, Acharya Abhinavagupt. Acharya Abhinavagupt. Acharya Abhinavagupt. The painter of this immensely touching pen picture of his guru, Acharya Abhinavagupt, Madhuraj, was originally a resident of Madurai in southern part of India. But his thirst for knowledge and self-realization brought him to Kashmir in the lap of Himalaya, the land of sages. Neither was the journey short, nor was the task easy, but his thirst for knowledge drew him towards the Enlightened One. The Lord of Lords, the Guru of Gurus, seated on the highest pedestal of the great systems of Siddhant, Kram, Bhairav, Yamal, Kaul, and other branches of Tantra and Shastras, he, only he, can be my preceptor. What a divine moment! What ecstasy it would have been for a seeker to get the first glimpse of his master, Acharya Abhinavagupt. The chapters of Indian history pertaining to such great men are important contributions from Kashmir. While describing the beauty of Kashmir in his literary works, Acharya Abhinavagupt says, "How beautiful is the land of Kashmir! How cool is the shade provided by the trees! How lively are these lovely fields of saffron! The mountain ranges full of scenic beauty, and the streams full of nectar flowing beneath them, adding new dimensions to life. Full of this diverse and amazing beauty, how can't the valley of Kashmir be beautiful?"
Acharya Abhinavagupt Bharat ke itihas mein vidwano mein ek vilakshan vibhuti hain. वह हर प्रकार से अद्भुत व्यक्ति हैं, लेकिन उनके व्यक्तित्व की जो सबसे बड़ी विशिष्टता है वह है एक प्रकार की समग्रता. अपने समय में जितनी भी विद्याएं थीं, चाहे वो तंत्र हो, चाहे वो योग हो, चाहे वो किसी प्रकार की साधना हो, अथवा साहित्य हो, संगीत हो, नाटक हो और विभिन्न प्रकार के दर्शन, उन सबको उन्होंने एक प्रकार से समाहित किया है. आचार्य अभिनवगुप्त व्यक्तित्व में भी समग्र विद्याओं को सिद्ध करने वाले व्यक्ति थे और उनके व्यक्तित्व में वो सब परिलक्षित होते हैं. भारत के सुदूर दक्षिण में भी उनको महामहेश्वर माना गया था और जिस प्रकार से उन्होंने विभिन्न मतों में शिक्षा ली थी, इसी तरह से वह जगह जगह से आने वाले शिक्षार्थियों को अपना ज्ञान बांटते रहे थे.
Acharya Acharya Abhinavagupt continued to light up the dark corners of ignorance by bringing forth the priceless, incomparable pearls of wisdom after immersing himself into the vast ocean of knowledge. His persona was a unique source of knowledge, which bestowed ease of understanding to Trig philosophy, Natyashastra and aesthetics, and added new dimensions to them. His towering genius, power of knowledge and philosophical outlook raised him to the level of an avatar during his lifetime. Many of his followers believe that Acharya Abhinavagupt was indeed a Bhairav incarnate. It is believed that Atrigupt, an ancestor of Abhinavagupt, lived in Kannauj province during the 8th century. In 740 AD, when Lalitaditya Muktapir, the then ruler of Kashmir, invaded and captured Kanyakubj, on his return, he brought with him a scholar Atrigupt. Nearly 200 years later, during the middle of the 10th century, Abhinavagupt was born in this family between 940 and 950 AD. Abhinavagupt's father was Sri Narasingha Gupt and his mother was Vimla, whom he refers to as Vimalkala in his writings as a mark of reverence. In addition to being a philosopher of Shaivism, Sri Narasingha Gupt was also a teacher of Sanskrit grammar. This is probably the reason for the early education of young Abhinav at home itself. In his magnum opus Tantralok, based on the Tantra philosophy, Abhinavagupt deviated from the centuries-old tradition of beginning a creative piece of writing with the invocation of Ishtadevi, or the goddess of the house. He starts the Tantralok with salutations to his parents, whom he revered as no less than any god or goddess. He expresses his respect and devotion to them by addressing his father as Panchamukha Gupt and mother Vimla as Mahajanani. The reason for this immense love and respect was also the loss of his mother at a very young age. This filled the compassionate mind of young Abhinav with vacuity and emptiness. He continuously looked for this idol of affection who was always around him like a shadow. The void thus created, the bouncing, flaring flames of his mother's pyre, the palm full of Jal Tarpan, raised some pertinent questions in the serene and tender mind of young Abhinav. The question of life and death, the crisscrossing and uneven lines between these two extremes. Is this what we call life? From the point of birth to the dot of death?
Ek bindu kendra hai, dusra hai hi nahi, kya hai ye?
Emerging from the vacuity of his mind, these and many such questions were clearly discovered by his father, Sri Narasingha Gupt, in the shimmer of Abhinav's eyes. Acharya Abhinavagupt's craving for accumulation of knowledge is unparalleled in history. To understand the different genres of philosophy, he inculcated knowledge from many eminent gurus. All these teachers and gurus were no ordinary humans, but accomplished practitioners, experts in their respective subjects, under whose mentorship Acharya Abhinavagupt attained a multifaceted, multidimensional scholastic stature, who was an epochal teacher. His pavanine splendor turns the tempestuous human mind into a bliss of infinite gleam even today.
Yah prakasha sasarvasya prakashatvam prayachati न च तद् व्यतिरेक्यस्ति विश्वं सद्भाव भासते.
One who is resplendent bestows a refulgent gleam to all. There is no exclusion. In his writings, Acharya Abhinavagupt has portrayed his gurus with great respect. While explicating Bharata's Natya Shastra in his Abhinav Bharati, he glorifies his guru Acharya Bhattathot like this.
Sadvi pratot vadano ditanatya veda tattvarthamarthi janavanchita siddhi hetoh Maheshwara Abhinavagupta pada pratishtha sankshipta vritti vidhina vishadi karoti.
For those seekers of knowledge who crave for the essence of Natya Shastra, which has been explained by my guru Acharya Bhattathot, I, Abhinavagupt, present my guru's explanation here. In the similar manner, while saluting another of his gurus, Bhatt Induraj, in his work Lochan, he writes,
Bhattinduraj charanabjakritadhivasa hritya shruto Abhinavagupta padabhidoham yat kinchidapyanuranan sphutayami kavya lokam svalochana niyo janaya janasya.
Sitting at the auspicious lotus feet of Sri Bhatt Induraj, the nuances and the meticulosities which I deciphered, I, Abhinavagupt, am elaborating them in my writing entitled Lochan, for an explicit understanding and better comprehension.
He praises all his gurus at the beginning of his work, especially a man called Shambhunatha, who came from Jalandhara, whose teacher was from South India called Sumati. At the beginning, he talks about his gurus and praises them as his standard form in India. And then at the end, he shows so much love and care and respect for his students that he likes to mention them also.
All the gurus of Abhinavagupt were renowned scholars, and so was the lineage of his disciples. It is believed that in Kashmir alone, he had about 10,000 disciples during his lifetime. And amongst them, Kshemaraj, Kshemendra, and Madhuraj Yogi, etc. were most outstanding. Acharya Abhinavagupt possessed an extraordinary intellect, which reflected vividly even in his disciples. For the guidance of his followers, Acharya Abhinavagupt says,
Mama sadhakeshu bhairavasya asmin marge yah kopi agatah sah brahmadah aspishyahva athva anya kopi tasya melanam param shiva tattvena sahaiva bhavishyati.
In Abhinav's ashram, along with the male disciples, there were female disciples too, called Shivadutis. In some religious books, they have been addressed as Parameshwari, as a mark of respect. This determines their place in devotion to Lord Shiva. After the untimely death of his mother, Abhinavagupt's widowed sister and the Shivadutis performed a special role to reduce the barrenness in his life.
Darat maja praprati bandh katha manata. Abhinavagupta is who has not married. But he had girlfriends to attend him. Because you see, motherly assistance is not done by men.
Abhinavagupta is believed to have authored about 41 works, most of which are extinct now. They were lost in the period of barbaric attacks by the outsiders. In addition to plunder, the offensive launched by marauders razed temples, the place of worship, and removed all such traces which were contrary to their fanatic philosophy. It is believed that whatever was left after this destruction got consolidated again due to the significant efforts made by Swami Ramji Maharaj. Swami Ramji Maharaj describes Abhinavagupt's magnificence in the following words. Wash your hands and feet, rinse your mouth well, and then, if you recite the name of Abhinavagupt, shall for sure attain moksha. For the protection, propagation and continuity of Shaiv philosophy, Swami Ramji Maharaj established a center in the Fateh Kadal area of Srinagar city. Children and youth were made aware of Kashmir Shaivism at this center. Swami Ramji Maharaj onward, this strict philosophy, though facing ups and downs along the tides of time, percolated down to reach Swami Lakshmanju. In Swami Lakshmanju's ashram, many Western scholars carried out research on Kashmir Thrik philosophy, along with their Indian counterparts. These scholars published many books based on their research and popularized Abhinavagupt's philosophy in countries across the globe. In this manner, the Thrik Shaiv philosophy propagated by Acharya Abhinavagupt retrieved Kashmir, its place of origin, back from the barbarian darkness and led it towards enlightenment through the path of self-realization.
I think you have read my book.
Yes, I have.
Edited by Paul Reps.
Yes.
The fourth book is mine there. The name of that fourth book is Centering.
Yes.
That is universal center, situated in each and every moment, between each and every moment. Between two thoughts, between two steps, between two talks, between two desires, between two acts, there is a center. And that center is to be focused with awareness. When you are focusing your mind towards that center, you will get entry in universal center.
In Swami Lakshmanju, I found a teacher who was both versed in knowledge and experience. He was considered to be the foremost authority on the philosophy called Kashmir Shaivism. He was extremely familiar with Abhinavagupta's teachings, which is the basis of Kashmir Shaivism as we read it today. This knowledge is so deep, it's so vast, and especially when you come into the arena of Abhinavagupta. I'm so drawn by this. And each day I read something and I realize I know nothing. There's a vast ocean of knowledge still to understand.
Abhinavagupta's works may be classified into four categories. 1. Original works. 2. Commentaries and critical writings. 3. Literary works. And 4. Devotional poems. His original writings include Tantralok, Tantrasar, Parmarthasar, Mahopadesh Vinshatika, Parmarth Charcha, Parmarth Dwadashika, Bodh Panchadashika, etc. Commentation and critical works include Pratyabhigya Vimarshini, Malini Vijayvartik, and Geetarth Sangraha. In his literary works, we have Abhinav Bharati and Bhanya Lok Lochan. And in the fourth category, his devotional poems include Bhairav Stotra, Kram Stotra, Anubhav Nivedan Stotra, Dehastha Devata Chakra Stotra, Anuttarashrika Stotra, etc. He
wrote works which were unique and absolutely standard on a commentary of Ananda Vardhana's Dwanya Loka, that dealt with poetics. He wrote a commentary, which is the only one survived, a very extensive, very complex and rich commentary on Bharat's Natya Shastra. And then in the third period of his life, he took an interest in the philosophy of Pratyabhigya, non-dualist Shaivism, in which he wrote commentaries on the Utpala Deva's Pratyabhigya Karika. He wrote one commentary called Vimarshini, which is quite a long commentary, but he wrote a much longer commentary called Vivriti Vimarshini. And these run into hundreds of pages, thousands. And it's not only the quantity, it's the quality, the acumen, the insight, the intelligence you have to apply to understand what he's saying.
Tantra Lok is the main work of Abhinavagupta. It is an extensive encyclopedia of Shaiv Tantra and devotion. It contains elaborate interpretations of both knowledge and ritual veneration. Being important from the philosophical point of view, it is also most important from the tantric devotional point of view. All dimensions of the universal processes and methodologies are well explained in it.
Iti jnana chatushtkam yat siddhi mukti mahodayam tanmaya tantrate tantra alok namnyatra shashane. नाम की घोषणा यहाँ पर कर रहे हैं और उस नाम की घोषणा के साथ कहते हैं उसमें चार चीज़ें उन्होंने बताई कि उसका नाम जो है तंत्रालोक है. तंत्रालोक है, तंत्रों की तरह से ये आलोकित करता है और तंत्रों को आलोकित करता है. इसका स्वरूप जो है शास्त्र का है. इसका प्रतिपाद्य जो है चार प्रकार के ज्ञान है जिनको हम चार उपायों के नाम से जानते हैं. और इसका फल जो है वो सिद्धि और मुक्ति इन दोनों को देने वाला है.
तंत्रोलका ही रोट ही डिडंट राइट ही स्पोक ही एक्सप्लेन्ड एंड हिज डिसिपल्स वर नोटिंग डाउन
दे टुक लाइक अ स्क्राइब
यस स्क्राइब
लाइक अ स्क्राइब एंड एनी अदर बुक दैट यू
37 डेज
37 डेज
37000 श्लोकस
तंत्रोलका इज अ 37 चैप्टर बुक वेरी वेरी यू नो इट इज अ बुक दैट नॉर्मली पीपल विद संस्कृत स्कॉलरशिप मे नॉट अंडरस्टैंड because this is a book shrouded in secret words. The vocabulary used, the kind of symbolism that is embedded in this book is all secret in the sense that it is not open to those people who are not initiated into this particular aspect of science. This is a science, believe me, it is a science. Because it's so analytical, so thought-provoking, so much, research-oriented, that there is so much wonderful components in this book that may not be understood by everybody, so he himself thought that he should write another book summarizing what is there in Tantraloka. And he, whereas who he wrote, you know, he wrote a commentary for Natashastra, he wrote a commentary for Dvanyaloka, and he writes a commentary for his own book, Tantraloka as Tantra Sara, which summarizes everything.
A great philosopher beyond the bounds of era or epoch, Acharya Abhinavagupt considered every element of nature as a means of self-realization.
Mulatah atmabodham atmanam cha shiva swarupe pratibhijnanasya prakriya mauna darshanasya sarah vartate parantu margoyam gyanarupatmakam prakash bindoho prapteh saral margah nasti shaiva darshanam margamenam sugamam karoti. तंत्र मंत्र यंत्राश्च साधनायाः उपकरणाः वर्तन्ते. तंत्र नाम किम्? तंत्र नाम दर्शनम्. मंत्रमित्युक्ते दैवीशक्तीनाम् आमंत्रणम् तथा च यंत्रमित्युक्ते साधनायाः उपकरणम्.
इन तंत्रालोक ही सेज
साहित्य सांद्र रस भोग परो महेश भक्त्या स्वयं ग्रहण दुर्मदया गृहीतः सतन्मयी भूयन लोक वर्तनी मजी गणत कामपि केवलं पुनः तदीय संभोग विवृद्धये पुरा करोति दास्यं गुरुवेश्मसु स्वयं.
Seeing Abhinavagupt besmeared in the nectar of his creative intellect, his beloved, the devotion to Shiva was aroused. As a consequence, ignoring all conventions, he too consented to the devotion to Shiva and accepted the servitude of his masters. Another important work of Abhinavagupt is Malini Vijayavartik. It relates to the practical aspects and ideologies of the basic elements and dualistic aspects in Shaiv philosophy. Though it deals with the knowledge of the topmost ideologies, yet it couldn't become popular because of its difficult explanations.
There is a point in a passage in the Malini Vijayavartika, which is one of the most difficult works of Abhinavagupta, and one of the least known because it's so difficult. There is an expression, anadara virakti. Abhinavagupta says it is useless to go against the senses, the passion, with strong means. Otherwise, you can obtain the opposite result. If you want to control, in a sense, lightly control your senses and your passion, you need a very special kind of detachment, a detachment played in elegant souplesse. This reminds us of the anadara nyasa in the Natya Shastra. Anadara nyasa is when somebody, usually an aristocrat, and a man, sakridaya man, is able to arrange very diverse elements to create a beautiful arrangement, giving the impression that you are not striving for this, but this comes naturally from your own taste, this anadara nyasa, arrangement, nice, beautiful arrangement, without thinking too much. The same you can find in this unique expression, anadara virakti. I think this is one of the key words in to understand Abhinavagupta.
Understanding the sum and substance of some of his literary works arouses one's curiosity to know more. Like in Ishwar Pratyabhigya Vimarshani, Acharya Abhinavagupta commentates on Utpaldev's Ishwar Pratyabhigya Karika, which is the first complete methodical writing on Pratyabhigya philosophy.
Abhinavagupta describes various components of Kashmiri Shaivism called the Pratyabhigya Shastra. This Shastra is called a Shastra that will only tell you what you have forgotten, you will recollect. That is the meaning of this shloka. This entire book will tell you nothing new. It only tells you are Shiva yourself. You have to reveal yourself, you have to understand yourself, you have to recollect yourself and realize that Jiva is Shiva and Atma is that Shiva.
The Dhvanyalok by Acharya Anandavardhan brought about revolutionary changes in Sanskrit poetics and made it vividly clear that the main objective of a good poetic creation is the experience of ras and bhav. Dhvanyalok can be translated as the light of sound. The sound here means suggestion. This can be experienced only when there is vision. For this reason, Abhinavagupta named his commentary Lochan, the eye, and most aptly so.
Abhinavagupta has given a brilliant commentary, and that is very, very important for all subsequent understanding of great poems written in India throughout its length and breadth. And so a knowledge of both Anandavardhana's work on Dhvanyaloka and also the commentary Lochana by Abhinavagupta are essential for understanding the beauty of Indian thought process, Indian communication process, and all great poetries can only be appreciated through their studies. So, for a proper appreciation of Indian approach to aesthetic realization, the study of both Anandavardhana and Abhinavagupta are absolutely essential.
His aesthetics is embedded in a whole philosophy and in a whole spirituality. And aesthetics and mysticism are very much related, as well as philosophy of recognition. So his contribution should be acknowledged also in the field of Tantra, because he was the greatest exegete of the Tantras.
Similarly, his Paratrimshika Vivaran also opens a repository of knowledge before the reader. It is an elaborate commentary in about 30 shlokas based on Paratrimshika Agam and is written in the form of a dialogue between Bhairav and Bhairavi. His contribution is considered significant in the historical context for his effortless and easy explanations on Trick philosophy, which not only helped in its understanding by the common people, but also played a lasting and effective role in spreading this school of thought. Trick Shaiv philosophy is based on non-dualism, which is designed around the relation between Nar, Shakti and Shiva. A creature, even after being of an inferior category, is basically a part of Shiv only. Shiv has created creatures out of his own self. Hence, he cannot be different from Shiv, the Supreme Self. By this logic, no special competence is required for practicing Shaiv sadhana.
Ye tantra tattva jo hai, kya hai? इस तंत्र तत्व को समझने के लिए उसको वो कहते हैं तीन प्रकार के त्रिक हैं यहाँ पर तीन प्रकार के परत्रिक अपरत्रिक और परापरत्रिक और इस जो जो उसको कर रहे हैं तो यो अभिनवगुप्त सारी बातें करते हैं लेकिन यह विशुद्ध दार्शनिक रूप से अभी देखिए तीन अंतरधाराएं इन त्रिकों के प्रतिपादन में हमें तीन अंतरधाराएं दिखाई दे रही हैं ऐतिहासिक सैद्धांतिक और दार्शनिक जब वो परत्रिक की उपासना करते हैं तो आप ये देखिएगा कि तांत्रिक शब्दावली में वो अनुत्तर त्रिक है अनाख्या रूप है लेकिन दार्शनिक शब्दावली में वो शिव शक्ति और उनका सामरस्य है ये परत्रिक है जब परत्रिक की बात करते हैं तो तांत्रिक शब्दावली में वो परा 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 और अपरा है लेकिन दार्शनिक शब्दावली में परा चित प्रतिभा है अपरा परा ज्ञान है और अपरा क्रिया है
Shiftere
Abhinav Gupt's elaborate commentary on the Natya Shastra of Bharat Muni enjoys the same importance in the field of performing arts as Tantra Loka does in Trik Shaiv philosophy. The majesty of Abhinav Bharati can also be gauged by the fact that some annotators call it Natya Ved.
Natya Ved kaise utpann hua? Uski baat वो समझा देते हैं पहले ही अध्याय में उसका स्वरूप क्या है उसको भी बता देते हैं पहले ही अध्याय में पहले ही चैप्टर में उसके स्वरूप को बता देते हैं उसका प्रयोग के साथ क्या संबंध है इसको भी उसको बता देते हैं और प्रमाण आदि की चर्चा कुछ आगे जाकर के करते हैं ये करके जो भी उससे संबद्ध बात है पहले ही अध्याय में आचार्य भरत मुनि भी वही करते हैं और उसकी व्याख्या को बढ़ा करके और स्पष्ट रूप से अभिनव भारती करती है
This book not only houses comprehensive explanations on the art of performance, theatre, innovations in expression, etc., but Abhinav Gupt regards Natyakala or the art of performance as means of self-realization and devotion. He considers poetry and aesthetics not only as a part of knowledge, but as knowledge per se.
नाट्य शास्त्र की कोई टीका अभी तक नहीं है, मिलती नहीं है। केवल एक टीका है अभिनव भारती, जो अभिनव गुप्त ने लिखी है, और ऐसी है कि जो कुछ भी उसमें प्राचीन था, नाट्य कैसे होता था, क्या था, इस सब का विवरण दिया है क्रमशः सिलसिलेवार, ऐसी माने क्रोनोलॉजी के साथ, अवेयरनेस ऑफ द हिस्ट्री, इसके साथ वो कहने वाले आचार्य वो तो कश्मीर में पैदा हुए। चाहे वो राजतरंगणीकार कल्लण हैं और चाहे अभिनवगुप्तपाद हैं, अद्भुत रूप से उनको अवेयरनेस है इस क्रोनोलॉजी की, हिस्ट्री की, वो कहते हैं, लेकिन वो हिस्ट्री में नहीं है, बियॉन्ड हिस्ट्री हैं, जाते हैं वहाँ तक जाते हैं। इसलिए यह है अभिनवगुप्तपाद की, अभिनव भारती का ये सबसे बड़ा है कि जो कुछ अभिनवगुप्त के पहले का है सब वो कह के फिर अपने आते हैं, देता है, और इसलिए अभिनव भारती की जो एकमात्र टीका है, अगर उसको हम न पढ़ें तो नाट्यशास्त्र को पढ़ना बिल्कुल संभव नहीं है।
Many dancers and dance acharyas were attracted to particularly the Karana sculptures in the Chidambaram temple, and everyone thought that these sculptures, because they are all sculptures, they thought Karanas are postures. And when we started studying Abhinav Bharati along with the Natyashastra verses, it was a fortunate day for me. It dawned on me, suddenly I was ordained to discover. I jumped out of my seat and I told my master, Mama means uncle, Karana is not a posture, it's a movement.
The great maestros and researchers in performing arts and poetics also believe that in addition to the explanation of Natyashastra, Abhinavagupta in his Abhinav Bharati made some amendments and added new dimensions to it, which made it easy for the common people to understand this unfathomable work.
Only after I started studying Abhinav Bharati, I could see with clarity what exactly the Bharata Sutras meant, because by following Bharata's sutras you get a vague idea of the movement, but when you follow Abhinav Bharati, details of the movements are explicit, and if you follow Bharata directly you get one form of action, and by adding the inputs from Abhinav Bharati you get a more refined action, because he has explained the Karanas from a practical point of view.
Summarizing Acharya Abhinavagupta's trick philosophy, writings and commentaries into a few pages or images is an effort to express too much in too little. His literary works are extraordinary, not only for their comprehensiveness, seriousness and high quality, but also for the wide range of his interests. They're an ideal for the whole humanity, especially in the modern times.
Abhinavagupta ko apni aitihasik bhumika ki chetna thi, to kehte hain कि सर्वो हि भाविनी परितोषमेति संभाविते न तु निमेषे वर्तमाने, क्षण जीवी वर्तमान के लिए हम नहीं लिख रहे हैं, हम तो उसके लिए लिख रहे हैं जो युगों तक प्रभावी रहे.
Such great saints remain not only as a source of knowledge from what they write or what they say, but a great inspiration to those that come before, spiritual inspiration.
The idea as given by Abhinavagupta has traveled to western part of India, Maharashtra, upper part of Karnataka, from where it reached the Tamil country, southern part of the country, and where it lives even today by way of abridgment and also translation.
Abhinavagupta will live forever. His tradition, his legacy, his intelligence, his inheritance of commentaries and understanding of the great stalwarts of our tradition is a boon for the present day generation of scholars and aesthetics, scholars and literature, scholars and music, scholars and dance, scholars and spiritualism, Shaivism and Tantra Shastra.
Acharya Abhinavagupta ke bare mein एक बात तो बड़ी स्पष्ट हो जाती है कि वह अपने समय से बहुत आगे देखते थे और आज के समय में जितनी भी समस्याएं हमारे सामने हैं कहीं ना कहीं उनके ग्रंथों में उस पर विचार मिलता है. शायद इसी कारण से हम उनको अभिनव कहते हैं क्योंकि वो अपने समय में भी नए थे और आज भी नए हैं और नयापन जीवन में किस प्रकार से निरंतर हो सकता है इसका मार्ग निर्देशन भी वह हमारे लिए करते हैं.
Like the birth of Acharya Abhinavagupta, not much is clearly known about his Nirvana too. It is believed that at the time of his salvation, he entered a cave. This cave can be found even today in the hillocks of Bhirva village in Kashmir. The Guru of Gurus, Acharya Abhinavagupta, had realized that now his job was complete here. And that it was time for him to go back. He had immense love for his disciples, and their practice too had touched the skies. How could the Guru leave them behind? During the course of entering the cave, the Bhairav Stotra which he recited mentions the date as well, which can be translated as, it is the 10th day of the waning moon of Posh month, and the year is 68. By 68 here, he means the year 4068, which comes to 4th January 1016, according to the Dominical calendar. Centuries ago, this light emanated from here. History stands as a tall witness that many marauders and devilish rulers occupied, looted, plundered, and vandalized everything. But this immortal and unfading light cut across all the storm that came in its way, and it kept on spreading itself in the whole world, and the expansion continues even today.
व्याप्त चराचर भाव विशेषम चिन्मयमेकम अनंतम अनादिम. इत्थम पोड भवन्मय संवित दीधितिदारित भूरित मिश्रः मृत्युयमांतक कर्म पिशाचय नाथ नमोस्तु न जातु विभेमि. व्याप्त चराचर भाव विशेषम चिन्मयमेकम अनंतम अनादिम. प्रोदित सत्य विबोध मरीच प्रोक्ष चित विश्व पदार्थ सतत्व भाव परामृत निर्भर पूर्णे त्वयम् अहमात्मनि निर्वृत्ति मेमि व्याप्त चराचर भाव विशेषम् चिन्मयमेकम् अनन्तमनादिम्।